Anyway, so I was thinking about what shall we do today? Because we've been talking about chords and about bending, you know, half steps and whole steps. And I want to kind of continue along that line, but I wanted to do something different. And this song is amazingly easy to play. And you know what? Until we started talking about all of this stuff, I never really learned to play this song without the music because I thought the chords were too hard. Now, even after all these years, I'm going, oh, you know, sometimes the logic is there and you miss it. Well, it hit me yesterday what the logic is with this song. So I'm going to teach you a really cool thing to do with your music. And if you're bored just playing C, F, and G chord and you want something new to do, well, there's three things. One, the chords for the song are chromatic chords, they're called. What does chromatic mean? It means they go down in half steps. Okay, a chromatic scale sounds like this. Right? Okay, so that's a chromatic up and down. And you hear good musicians do that all the time. They're playing chromatics. Okay? So, along with chromatic scales, there is also something called chromatic chords. So on the back are all the instructions that you need. I'm going to teach you chromatic chords. There's a little chord progression in there that's called the Bugs Bunny chord progression. And Greg and I named it, but that's okay. You won't find it. Name that in any other book. But we call it Bugs Bunny progression. And then I'm going to teach you a theater ending with chromatic chords that's really cool and very easy to do. Okay? All right. So to start with, let's just listen to the melody. Follow along with me while I play it. So watch the melody. And then back to the theme. Okay, so the first part goes twice. And look, it just goes down in half steps. Then the bridge is the fourth line. Then back to the beginning. Sharp it. See? And you know, and then by the time you're done, you know all the chords. Yay! Okay, then you go back. You play it backwards. All right. I'm having a hard day. All right. You can also do this in the inversions. So here's a C chord inverted, right? If you play it like this, you can play it like this, or you can play it like this. So most of you play it like that, I'm guessing. So now if you want to do chromatic chords with this inverted, same thing. Sharp, sharp, sharp. Sharp, sharp, sharp. Sharp, sharp, sharp. And you just move the chords up in half steps like that. I prefer to do them, if I'm going to do this, in the root position. But if you're going to play this song, you shouldn't. You should play the C chord, C, E, G. Or G, C, E. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk back.
And you're gonna do that.
Oh, okay.